Hello there! In this video, we'll be showing you how to paint your Attilan Rough Riders. By following this guide, you can paint the rest of the box set with the same colours. We'll be painting quickly and efficiently to get your models looking great and on the battlefield in no time at all. The first thing we've done is undercoat our model, and for this colour scheme, we've used grey sear. We will also tidy up any areas that we need to with grey sear from the pot. Ready your Imperial Steeds and keep true to the ancestors of the Steppes of Atilla. It's time to paint our Rough Rider Sergeant. The awesome thing about this guide is that it uses just 10 paints. Those paints are on the screen now. Remember that these are our recommendations. Feel free to paint your miniatures however you like. If you are new to painting, or want to know the paints and techniques used in this video, check out our Citadel Colour Painting Essentials videos in the description. For our first paint, we'll be using Mournfang Brown and applying it all over the horse. You can afford to be messy at this point, as we will be painting over all the other details later on with other paints. Once you've covered all the horsehair details, let the paint dry and then do another coat in order to get good coverage. With the horse picked out, that's the largest part of the model completed. Our next paint will be Thunderhawk Blue, and we'll use it to pick out all of the blue cloth on the horse. We're looking to pick out the top section of the cloth with Thunderhawk Blue and leave the grey sear underneath the cloth. This will give that nice two-tone effect that we see on the box art. Once again, you can afford to paint quite freely here. However, try and be neater when going near the horse details. We will need multiple thin coats here in order to build up the right coverage. This is because Thunderhawk Blue is a layer paint, therefore a bit thinner than a base paint, but it is the exact colour that we need. There we go. With that stage complete, it's now time to paint some details on the rider. For this step, we'll be using Hoeth Blue to pick out the coat and clothes of the rider. Hoeth Blue is a perfect colour for this, as it has a different tone than Thunderhawk Blue, but visually looks similar. This ties in with the box art and helps to identify the difference between where the cloth on the horse ends and the rider detail starts. Again, Hoeth Blue is a layer paint, so you will need multiple coats to build up a strong and solid base. Hoeth Blue looks great next to Thunderhawk Blue, and once we apply shades later in the video, we will really tie the rider and mount together. We will now use Rhinox Hide to pick out all the large leather details on the horse and rider. We're looking to pick out leather satchels, gloves, holsters, bags, boots, and the horse's mask under the armor panels. For you, you can choose any parts you want to paint in Rhinox Hide, as these are just our recommendations for how we've done this tutorial using 10 paints. Remember, it's your model to paint how you want. And there we go, the brown leather details are complete. It's time to pick out the black details, and for this, we will use Abaddon Black. We're looking to pick out the horsehair, hooves, harness, and straps, weapon details, as well as the reins. A benefit of using Abaddon Black now is that you can paint over all the overspill on these details from earlier in the process. Abaddon Black has great coverage, but we always suggest that multiple thin layers are better than one thick layer. So just remember to thin out your paint before applying it to the model. The black details are complete. It's time to add a spot color. For our spot colour, we'll be using Corn Red to tie in with the red armour details we see on the box art. Therefore, we'll pick out the shoulder pads, helm and lenses, and then pick out various satchels and bits of equipment on the mount. This helps to tie the whole model together, as well as making it visually interesting. Just remember to be neat when going around the previously painted details, but if you make any mistakes, you can always tidy back up with the previous layers. With the corn red applied, we've added a lot of visual interest to our model. It's time to pick out the metallics. And for our first one, we will use Lead Belcher to pick out all the silver metallic details. These are the horse armor, weapons, buckles, horseshoes, gas mask, and broken terrain. If you get lost where these details are, you can always check the box art. Try and be as neat as you can when picking out these details, as this will help reduce time with tidying up. With this stage complete, our Attilan Rough Rider Sergeant is really starting to come together. For our second metallic paint, we will use Rune Lord Brass to pick out the horse's eye armour, sergeant's chevrons, and the trim detail for the weapons and badge. And there we are, all the main colours for our Attilan Rough Rider Sergeant are complete. It's time to add some depth and flavour to the model. We are now entering the shading phase. And our shade of choice for this video will be Agrax Earthshade. This is because it is the perfect shade for the horse, as well as acting as a shade and weathering paint for our other details. When applying it over the model, thin it down with a 2-to-1 ratio of water to shade paint, and cover the whole model. When your ratio of 2-to-1 water is dry on the model, if you need to add it anywhere else in specific areas, now's the chance to do that as well. Once it's dry, then use Agrax Earthshade straight from the pot over the lower sections of the cloth of the horse and rider. Remember to pick out the inside of the cloth as well. Weathering here adds so much interest and character to our model. It also gives the feel that our model is in the middle of the battle and charging towards the enemy. There we are. We've added a lot of character to our model, with just one paint used in multiple ways. It's time for our final paint, and for this we'll be using Runefang Steel to edge highlight the armour. Take your time when doing this and pick out the edges of all the silver and brass details. You can also add little scratches and marks by just dragging your brush across the larger, flatter sections. When adding battle damage, less is always more for this step. There we are, our model is now fully painted. With that last step complete, your Attilan Rough Rider Sergeant is finished and ready to lead your Rough Riders in the charge against all enemies of the Imperium. You can see that our model is based in Armageddon Dunes, but you can base it in any colour you like. If you want to learn more about basing, check out our technical paints video on how to base your models. Well, we hope you've enjoyed this video and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye!